Hey everyone, this is Levi with Between Two Lines. I'm gonna start this one off with a giveaway. This Carhartt beanie is up for grabs. I know what you're thinking. It's the most beautiful beanie I've ever seen in my life, and it could be yours. To be entered into the drawing, all you've gotta do is share this video on whatever diabetic Facebook group you're a part of. I don't care if it gets posted 27 times. If you share the video, you're entered into the drawing next week. I'll announce the winner, and we'll get this bad boy sent out to you. So today, let's talk about the dawn phenomenon. Liver dump, those unexplained times when your blood sugar rises without cause. The liver dump or dawn phenomenon, if you're not familiar with these terms, I'm certain you're familiar with the concept, is those times when your blood sugar rises without cause, without reason. There's a couple instances that in particular cause this, and those are the two I'm going to focus on today. One is in the morning when you wake up, the dawn phenomenon of rising blood sugar. And the second one is anaerobic exercise. When you start working out, lifting weights in the gym, a lot of people have a common problem of their blood sugar being in a spike. We're going to talk about why that is, maybe some things that you can do, some things that I've had success with, and maybe some ways to improve your relationship with your type 1 diabetes. We spend all of our time managing our blood sugar. This food affects my blood sugar in this way. I've got to give this much insulin for this. The supplies, dealing with the all the above. And sometimes I find myself losing focus of the name of the game. The blood glucose is energy. That's all it is. That's the energy for our body. It's the fuel we run on. All of our interior processes, all the exterior activities we do are fueled by glucose. Our bodies are extremely precise at managing this. And the delivery of the glucose and when we need what and how much and when to cut back. And there's a lot of automated processes that the normal human body does extremely well. As a diabetic, you've got a table with one of your legs broken off of it and you're responsible for holding up that corner of the table by acting as your own pancreas. Yet some of these automated processes continue to happen. One of those is a liver dump, or a liver dumping glucose into your bloodstream at a time that it deems needed. So what's causing that? Supply and demand. When your body's physical demands or activity rises, a lot of times if the fuel's not in the tank, the liver will dump glucose into your bloodstream to meet those demands. The perfect example is the morning, that dawn phenomenon. When you wake up in the morning, your blood sugar begins to rise. And what's going on there is you've essentially fasted for a period of time. You've slept all night, so you haven't been eating. You woke up in the morning. Your muscles and skeletal muscles draw the glucose out of the bloodstream to fuel and start your day. Well, your liver recognizes that and see that there's no glucose coming. You haven't eaten anything. And so it will spill, or that's not a good word, more like disperse glucose into your bloodstream. The rate at which it does that is directly dependent upon the rate at which your muscles absorb the glucose. Your body can read how fast it's happening and will dispense glucose accordingly. So in the morning on an empty stomach and you've been asleep, your heart rate increases, you're stretching, you're yawning, you're getting out of bed. It'll draw the glucose out of your bloodstream to start your day, and it causes that liver dump that can spike your blood sugar. I am a poster child for a morning dawn phenomenon. I'm not sure if it's that way for everybody. In fact, I know some people have it worse and some people not so much, but when I get up in the morning, boom, it's off to the races. My blood sugar is rising. Last night was the perfect example. The night before I filmed this episode, and I took screenshots, so I'm going to put them somewhere up here. I had a perfect night. I nailed it. All night long, my blood sugar was perfect. The moment I woke up, when my feet hit the ground, my blood sugar started to rise, and it does it fast. You can see on the graph. 30, 45 minutes later, I ate breakfast and then bolused or gave a shot for that amount. The critical mistake that I made is I didn't take into account the dawn phenomenon. So my blood sugar keeps rising. It tapered off, but it was still rising. And I had to re-administer insulin to counter for the morning dawn phenomenon to get me to come back down. It took hours. It wasted my whole morning and jacked up my whole day. That's the dawn phenomenon. So what you can do to combat that is going to take some attention on your part. I've said before, you can't improve what you don't measure. So you're going to need to pay attention to how quickly and how often your blood sugar rises in the morning. And then what you can do is give a shot or a bolus on your insulin pump before you even get out of the bed in the morning. The moment you wake up, you give that set amount and it's gonna counter your dawn phenomenon, and then you'll give an appropriate insulin with the food you eat later. That should help level things out. It's helped me tons. So that's the name of this channel, is me trying to share some of the things I've screwed up or some of the things I've had benefit from. That's one of them. So give that a shot if you're not already doing that. Second thing is anaerobic exercise. I say anaerobic, there's two kinds, aerobic and anaerobic. If you're not familiar with the two, do a little bit of research, there's a significant difference between them. We're going to talk about anaerobic because that can cause a liver dump as well. What's going on there? Same exact thing. The demands of your body have increased. All of a sudden, you're introducing stress to your body. You're working out. It's a stressor. The different hormones are coming into play, and all of a sudden, boom, the body's demands are higher, and the liver will respond by dumping glucose into your bloodstream. And so there's a lot of people in the different groups that comment like that, hey, I'm working out. My blood sugar's rising. Do I give insulin for that, or what are you guys doing? I seem to run high for a little while. It's everybody's experienced a lot of the same thing to a different degree. Me personally, didn't happen to me very much, but the mornings are terrible for me. That's the hardest time of the day. Others, their workouts are a mess. It's a little bit different though. The difference is your body can absorb the glucose from your bloodstream into the muscles without insulin when they're very active in a stressful anaerobic setting like that. It can use the glucose without the insulin. Now, as a diabetic, I caution you against bolusing against that liver dump that starts in your workout, because you could shoot yourself in the foot and wind up low 30 minutes later. And if you've done that, you know the drill. What I've done, and this is not a doctor, it's just me passing on something I've tried, maybe bolus a percentage or give it a shot that's only a percentage of what you think you need. I go at half. So whatever the rise is, I'll give half that amount of insulin that I would usually use to correct. One thing I've found with anaerobic exercise is that it's a bit of a fight or flight response. You know, you've boom, introduce all this stress, this high energy workout. Your body dumped a certain amount of sugar in there to combat that. But if you don't continue to provide maximum effort the way you would if you were running from a bear in the woods or were in some kind of emergency situation, if you back off your workout and you're not giving it your all, it was too much sugar and you stay high. It's easier said than done. I'll be the first to tell you, I'll lie to you all day long and tell you I work 100% at every one of my workouts. But it's not the case. None of us are able to truly motivate ourselves to 100% every time, or there wouldn't be an industry full of personal trainers there to provide motivation. But anything you can do to dial it up will help combat that liver dump that happens at the beginning of anaerobic exercise. So hopefully those two things will help. Those are two instances I deal with on a daily basis, just trying to give what I can back to you guys. If you would, leave a comment on what you found, because if you watch this video and you're an expert, you can recognize that I'm not. If you watch this video and you're a novice, hopefully you picked up something from me. So this is a two-way conversation. So leave in the comments anything you have to contribute, because I, as much as anyone else, am looking for ways to improve my relationship with type 1 diabetes, just like you. This is Levi. I look forward to talking to you guys next week. Don't forget to share the video on your Facebook group to be entered for the Carhartt Bean. Thanks a lot. See you next week.